Good evening, Revive Church. Happy New Year. We are back at the Norris Center after being gone for a week. We missed you guys, but we are back. And my name is Courtney.
And I'm Shreya, and we serve on the Dream Team.
We do. And we are here at the Norris Center in San Antonio. So if you are anywhere in the area and you want to join us, we want you to be here with us. We start at 6 p.m., so you have time to get here. We start at worship, which is going to be phenomenal today. And, y'all, we are starting our new series called Limitless. That is our prophetic word for 2022. And I am so excited to start learning all about what God has in store for us concerning Limitless.
Yep. So we are starting off the year with our corporate fast, and we really want you to be a part of it. So if you want to get the information on our fast, all you have to do is text the word prayer to 830-209-0808. Again, that is text the word prayer to 830-209-0808. And for the next week from January the 3rd through the 7th, we are doing 5 a.m. prayer. So that is the foundation of our ministry here at Revive. Mm-hmm. Phenomenal things happen when you take that time out to give God the first of the day. So 5 a.m. prayer for the next 7 days.
Yes, 5 a.m. prayer starts tomorrow. It is a Zoom link that we can send y'all as soon as you text prayer to 830-209-0808. Simply text the word prayer. You'll get a Zoom link. You can join all of us tomorrow. You don't have to be a part of Revive Church, but we want you to be a part of our 5 a.m. prayer fasting that starts tomorrow for a week. So make sure you text prayer.
Make sure that you also are connecting with us online via social media, via Facebook and Instagram. You know, guys, we are back into 2022, okay? So give me a second to get this together. But
we were on vacation, y'all.
We really were. We want you guys to be a part of what God is doing here. And to get our prayer points, you can also look on our social media.
Yeah.
Pastor has the points that we're going to be praying for the next 21 days. Mm-hmm. So I know for the first 7 days, we're doing 5 a.m. prayer. We want you to be a part. But for 21 days, we are giving God the first of the year. And 21 days, we're fasting.
Yes. And after the end of our fast, which would be January 23rd, we are giving our limitless offering. So Pastor will talk some more about what all that is. So make sure that you are tuned in tonight to hear all about that. We want you to share this. Share this with all of your friends, all of your family. Everybody needs to hear the limitless word that Pastor is bringing y'all for the year 2022.
Y'all. He's bringing us, okay? Because I'm a part of the limitless.
Y'all's.
Our. He is bringing clarity to what limitless is.
Yes.
And at the end of last year, he gave us a glimpse. And I was excited because I started, declaring limitless then. So if you already started declaring the end of your 2021 and you already ready and geared up for limitless 2022, I'm telling you, you want to be a part of the fast. Yep. You want to be a part of tonight, and you want your friend circle to be a part of tonight. So share it. Send it to them. Let them know, because once you touch and agree with this limitless word, it's an overflow.
Speaking of being a part, we want you to be a part of Revive Church. So if you were wondering, what is Revive Church? Who is Revive Church? What do they believe in? What is their vision? What is their mission? All of that. You can join Growth Track. Growth Track is going to be called Inside Revive.
Yep.
So it is a class that Pastor comes in and teaches, and you can learn all about Revive Church.
Where you fit, how you can join our ministry, what your ministry gifts are. That was one of the most exciting parts for me of what's inside of Revive. That's where we learned some of our ministry strengths and what God had placed inside of us. So if you want to join our team, make sure that you text the word GROW to 830-209-0808.
So just a quick recap. Starting tomorrow for 1 week, we are going to be 5 a.m. prayer. If you want to be a part of 5 a.m. prayer, you don't have to be a part of Revive Church, but we want you to be a part with us tomorrow at 5 a.m. for 1 week. All you have to do is text the word prayer to 830-209-0808, and you can get all that information. We are going into 2020 strong, limitless, and we want you to be a part of it with us. So text that number, prayer. You can also text GROW. You can text all sorts of things to that number to get any kind of information that you want for Revive Church. But tonight, we are starting the Limitless series. We are so excited. Share this broadcast with all your friends, all your family.
Estoy en la tormenta, mi corazón no temerá. Cuando estoy desesperado, tu mano no me soltará. Cuando me encuentro sin aliento, yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien. Yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien. El mar abrirás, tu mano. siempre tú lo haces bien. Al caminar por esos valles, tú vas conmigo, tú eres fiel. Porque sé, tú no me dejas, tú me rodeas y no temeré. Cuando me encuentro sin aliento, yo sé que todo siempre
tú haces bien.
Yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien. El mar abrirás,
el mar abrirás, tu mano lo hará, tu amor todo lo vencerá. Yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien.
Y en la oscuridad a mi lado vas, siempre permaneces. En cada temor de tu mano voy, siempre me sostienes. En la oscuridad a mi lado vas, siempre,
siempre permaneces.
En cada temor
de tu mano voy, siempre
en la oscuridad vamos. En la oscuridad a mi lado vas, siempre
permaneces.
En cada temor de tu mano voy, siempre me sostiene. Yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien. Yo sé que todo
siempre tú lo haces bien.
El mar abrirás, tu mano lo hará, tu amor todo lo vencerá. Yo sé que todo
siempre tú lo haces bien.
El mar abrirás, tu mano lo hará, tu amor todo lo vencerá. Yo sé que todo siempre tú lo haces bien.
Ooh. show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me, and I will build my life upon your love. It is a
let us bow down before Him. His banner is love over us. His mercies are new every morning. We sing, oh.
Return is you alone, walk the cornerstone, high within our hearts,
high within our hearts.
So we lift you, and so we lift you high,
forever,
forever lift you high,
high within our hearts,
high within our hearts,
and high within our
hearts.
Jesus, you alone.
Jesus, you alone.
Our rock, our cornerstone.
Rock, our cornerstone.
High within our hearts.
High within our hearts. High within our hearts.
Just sing that again, church. Say, so we lift you forever. High within our hearts. And high within our minds, Jesus. Sing, Jesus, you alone, my rock, my cornerstone, high within my heart, oh, high within our minds, and so we lift you high,
forever lift you high,
high within
couple of minutes. Why don't you just begin to lift up your voice, church? Come on, just in your own words, begin to worship him. There's something that happens when you begin to stir up the worship inside of you. Jesus. We're just going to give you some space to worship your King. We give you the room, we give you the room, we give you the room. We give you the room, we give you the room. This is your house, this is your house. This is your house, this is your house, this is your house. This is your house, this is your house. Let us abide in your glory. Let us abide in your glory. We're here for you. We're here for you. We're here for you. We're here for you, Jesus. We're here for you. We're here for you, Jesus. We're here for you. We're here for you, Jesus. Hey, we're here for you. We're here for you, Jesus.
Here I am to part. Here I am to say, you're my God. You're altogether worthy, altogether lovely, altogether wonderful to me. Just tell him. So here I am to worship. Here I am to bow. Here I am to say that you're my God. You're altogether lovely. You're altogether worthy. Altogether wonderful too. Come on, let's just tell them like that, church. So here I am to worship. Here I am.
Just begin to worship the King. Come on. Begin to lift up the name of Jesus in the room. Our worship belongs to you, Jesus. Our worship belongs to you, Jesus. Our worship belongs to the King. Myself away, I give myself away so you can use me. I give myself away. Oh, oh, oh. I give myself away so you can use me, God. So you can use this vessel. Come on, just sing that out. I give myself away. Come on, sing it out. So you can use me. I give myself every ounce inside of me, every breath in my lungs, every thought, God, every dream, every desire, it's yours. I give it to you. 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 I give myself away. I give myself away. I give myself. See, my life is not my own. Come on. My life is not my own. To you I belong. I give myself to you. My life is not my own. To you I belong.
and ears to hear what you want to speak tonight. We bind up every distraction, every thought, every event that occurred before now that would come and hinder and distract. We bind it up in the name of Jesus. And we declare that our minds are free. Our minds are clear to hear the voice of God, to hear the voice of His Spirit speaking tonight. Thank you, Father, because we know you have a direct word for us. Speak to our hearts. Thank you, Jesus. Why don't you give Him an applause and give honor to the King of Kings, because He is worthy of our praise. He is worthy of it all. Thank you, Jesus. Welcome to Revive Church. I am Pastor Leslie Renovato, and the vision of our house is to lead people to encounter God, His presence, and His power. And so if you are here tonight, it's because you've desired something more within you. And I promise you that you will not leave this place the same. God's presence is here, and He desires to touch every single one of your hearts. So whatever you came with, if you came with a burden, if you came with something, just let it go and be free in His presence tonight. God has something powerful for every single one of us. I promise you. So open your ears to hear and to receive everything God has for you. I want you to greet your neighbor, and I want you to give him a big hug and say, Happy New Year. Welcome back. We took a little break last week, but we are so happy to see every single one of you. Find someone, greet them, give them a big smile. And you may have your...
Bless you, Revive Church. How's everyone doing tonight?
Bienvenidos a Iglesia Revive. ¿Cómo
Come on,
están
if you're
todos?
Excited, put your hands together and give
si
God
están
praise.
Emocionados, pongan sus manos juntos y dale gloria.
Welcome.
Bienvenidos.
To the best place to be on a Sunday night.
Al mejor lugar estar por un domingo por la noche.
We truly believe
verdaderamente creemos
that being in the presence of God
que estando en la presencia de Dios
is the best place you can be
es
on,
el mejor lugar
on
que tú puedes
any
estar
night,
en cualquier noche.
But especially on a Sunday night.
Pero especialmente en un domingo por la noche.
We are excited to have each and every one of you here tonight.
Estamos emocionados de tener cada uno de ustedes aquí con nosotros.
If this is your first time with us,
si esta es tu primera vez con nosotros,
we are the pastors.
Nosotros somos los pastores
of this beautiful house called Revive Church.
De esta casa hermosa llamada Iglesia Revive.
Pastor Humberto, my wife Leslie.
Pastor Humberto y mi esposa Leslie.
And our vision here at Revive.
Y la visión aquí en Iglesia Revive. Es para guiarlos,
to encounter God,
a encontrarse con
His
Dios,
presence,
su presencia
and His power,
y su poder.
Not just on a Sunday,
no solamente por un domingo,
but just every single day.
Pero todos los días.
And what we desire tonight,
y lo que deseamos en esta
is
noche,
that each one of you in this room,
es que cada uno de ustedes en este lugar,
would encounter the presence of God.
Se encuentren con la presencia
it's
de Dios.
It's not just about having an amazing worship service.
Tenemos un servicio increíble.
It's not just about
no se trata de solamente tener un servicio increíble,
but it's about encountering God each and every day of your life.
Pero se trata de encontrarte con Dios todos los días de tu vida.
And if you're looking for a house to be a part of,
y si tú estás buscando una casa para ser parte,
we have a way that you can do that with us tonight.
Tenemos una manera que tú puedes
and
hacer eso.
You can simply text the word new.
Simplemente puedes mandar un mensaje nuevo
to a number on the screen.
Al número en la pantalla.
And you can get connected with our house.
Y se pueden conectar con la casa.
Be part of what God is doing in this beautiful city of San Antonio.
Ser parte
parte de lo que Dios está haciendo en esta ciudad de San Antonio,
if you want to be part of, we have a simple way to do that.
Tenemos una manera simple de hacer
to
eso.
Get involved into the vision of this house.
Involucrarse en la visión de esta casa.
We have something called Growth Track.
Tenemos algo llamado
and
Growth
what
Track.
What it is, it's a way for you to learn about the culture and the community of this house.
Y lo que es a poder aprender la cultura y la, de la comunidad
and
de esta
the vision
casa
of this house.
Y de la visión de esta
and
casa.
You can simply text the word grow.
Y simplemente puedes mandar la, la palabra crecer.
And you can be part of that with us.
Y puedes ser parte de eso con nosotros.
But we have some amazing things coming up for this month of January. How many of y'all are excited for the new year 2022?
¿Cuántos están emocionados por el nuevo año 2022?
Come on, we are a church of celebration.
Nosotros somos una iglesia de celebración.
So we love to shout, we love to praise.
Nos gusta gritar y adorar.
Don't get freaked out.
No se asusten.
But tomorrow,
pero mañana,
January 3rd,
en el 3 de enero,
through January 23rd,
hasta el 23 de este
we
mes,
are starting a 21-day fasting and prayer.
Vamos a comenzar un ayuno de 21 días.
Y'all see how y'all didn't shout right there?
Mira cómo nos gritaron ahí.
Y'all see, well, as soon as we said fasting and prayer,
de,
pronto, can you put it up on the screen?
Dijimos ayuno.
We have 21 days of fasting and prayer.
Vamos a estar ayunando por 21 días.
Each and every day,
y cada día,
we're going to be seeking the Lord.
Vamos a estar buscando al Señor.
You know, fasting is the ability to get clarity from God.
El ayunar es la habilidad de poder tener claridad de parte de Dios.
And when you fast,
y cuando tú ayunas,
you are doing an exchange.
Estás haciendo un intercambio.
You're exchanging something natural.
Estás intercambiando algo natural.
In exchange for something supernatural.
Por algo sobrenatural.
So as your pastor, can I pastor y'all tonight?
Los puedo pastorear, está bien con esto?
Can you hear the pastor's heart?
Pueden escuchar el corazón del pastor.
If you're part of this house,
si tú eres parte de esta iglesia,
we begin the year always with a fast.
Siempre comenzamos el año con un ayuno.
And I want to challenge all our leaders.
Y quiero retar a todos los líderes.
Our serve team, our members.
Nuestro equipo de servicio, nuestros miembros.
Each and every one of you that feel the challenge tonight.
Cada uno de ustedes que sientan el reto en esta noche.
To dedicate the first 21 days to the Lord.
Que dediquen en los primeros 21 días al Señor.
And we're going to enter this thing in a fast.
Y vamos a entrar con este ayuno.
And the challenge for you all.
Y el reto para todos.
Is to take something in the natural.
Es tomar algo en lo natural.
When you fast, normally we fast food.
Cuando uno ayuna, normalmente ayunamos comida.
So we separate ourselves from meat.
Entonces separamos la carne.
Red meat, chicken.
La carne roja,
fish,
pollo,
pescado. Like and we separate ourselves from those things.
Y nos separamos de esas cosas.
We fill ourselves with more veggies and fruit.
Y nos llenamos de vegetales y frutas.
And, it's what we know as the Daniel fast.
Es como lo decimos el
so,
ayuno de Daniel.
I want you to pray about what it is that God needs you to fast.
Entonces yo quiero que ustedes oren para que Dios te diga qué tienes que ayunar.
What do you need to separate yourself from?
De qué te tienes que separar.
So that you can receive more clarity to hear God's voice.
Para que puedas recibir más claridad y escuchar la voz de Dios.
And beginning tomorrow.
Entonces comenzando mañana.
All our leaders, if you part of our serve team at Revive.
Si tú eres parte del equipo de servicio aquí en esta iglesia.
We do this every week.
Lo hacemos todas las semanas.
But starting tomorrow.
Pero comenzando mañana.
We are actually going to open it up to all of you that are in this room.
Vamos a abrirlo para todos
those
en
of you
este
watching
cuarto,
online.
Todos los que están viendo por línea.
And we do something at 5 a.m. each and every day.
Y nosotros hacemos algo a las 5 de la mañana
so
todos los días.
So beginning tomorrow,
empezando mañana,
for this first week of the fast,
para la primera semana de este ayuno,
we're inviting you to be part of our 5 a.m. prayer.
Los vamos a invitar que sean parte de nuestra
and
oración a las 5 de la mañana.
Tonight,
entonces si quieres el
you
enlace,
can get your phone out right now,
puedes sacar tu teléfono,
text prayer,
manda un mensaje
to that
oración
number on the screen right now,
a ese número en la pantalla,
and you're going to get a text back and with the Zoom link beginning tomorrow.
Y vas a recibir un texto de nuevo con el enlace para esa junta.
We want you to be part of our 5 a.m. prayer.
Queremos que sean parte de nuestra oración a las 5 de la mañana.
All our team is going to join at 5 a.m. right, serve team.
Todo nuestro equipo se va a juntar a las 5 de la mañana.
Y'all here, get excited if you're part of 5 a.m. prayer.
Vamos, emocionense si eres son parte de.
So at 5 a.m.
a las 5 de la mañana.
We want you to join. You don't have to have your camera on.
No tienes que prender tu cámara.
We don't want to see your face at 5 a.m.
No queremos ver tus.
But I want you to join us at 5 a.m. starting tomorrow. And,
pero quiero que estén con nosotros a las 5 de la mañana.
And we're going to be fasting and praying and seeking the Father's heart.
Y vamos a estar ayunando y buscando el corazón del
Padre. It's going to be a powerful time.
Y va a ser algo poderoso.
We also want to remind all of you all
también les queremos recordar
that we have our limitless offering.
que tenemos nuestra ofrenda de,
this is our first fruit offering.
Esta es nuestra ofrenda de primicias.
And we are going to be honoring God.
Y vamos a honrar a Dios.
On January 23rd.
El 23 de enero.
We're going to turn in the fast.
Vamos a entregar el ayuno.
And then we're going to give to the Lord our first fruit offering.
Y vamos a darle al Señor nuestra primicia.
If y'all remember back in December.
Si se acuerdan en diciembre.
We began the challenge.
Nosotros comenzamos el reto.
To separate one day's worth of work.
Separando un día de trabajo.
For the next weeks.
El salario de un día para las próximas semanas.
And that has been our challenge.
Y ese ha sido nuestro reto.
Many of us are in this room took on that challenge.
Muchos de nosotros tomamos ese reto.
But at the end of tonight's service, I want you to grab one of these limitless envelopes.
Pero al final del servicio quiero que agarren un sobre que dice sin límites.
And these are going to be the envelopes that we're going to bring to the Lord on January 23rd.
Y estos son los sobres que vamos a traer ante el Señor el 23 de enero.
And I want us to honor God because when you put God first in everything you do.
Y tenemos que honrar a Dios porque cuando tú pones a Dios primero en todo lo que tú haces.
The Bible says seek first.
La palabra dice busca primeramente el reino de Dios.
And everything else will be added on.
Y todo lo demás será añadido.
When you talk about first,
cuando uno habla de primero,
you're talking about priority.
Estamos hablando de prioridad.
And you're saying seek first in priority.
Si buscas primeramente en prioridad el reino de Dios.
And so we're giving God our first fruit.
Entonces vamos a darle a Dios nuestras primicias.
Because he deserves first priority.
Porque él merece prioridad.
Amen.
Amen.
So that's what we're going to do on January 23rd.
Entonces eso es lo que vamos a hacer el 23 de enero.
It's going to be an awesome time. So tomorrow begins a fast.
Mañana comienza el ayuno.
And on January 23rd we're going to give to the Lord our first fruit offering.
Y el 23 vamos a dar nuestra ofrenda de primicias.
Is Revive Church excited to be in the house tonight?
Estamos emocionados de estar aquí.
Because y'all look dead tonight. No,
porque se ven
I want you to stand up to your feet. We're going to go into the word of the Lord tonight.
Pónganse de pie. Vamos
stand up to your feet.
Palabra.
And if you got your Bible, your iPhone, or you want to put your eyes on the screen,
y si tienen su palabra,
you can
su
as
teléfono,
well.
O pueden ver la pantalla.
We're going to begin this first week of January with a prophetic word that we released.
Vamos a comenzar este mes con una palabra profética.
And I want you to go with me to 1 Chronicles chapter 22.
Y quiero que vayan conmigo a Segunda de Crónicas capítulo 2.
First Chronicles chapter 22.
22, capítulo 22. Primera de Crónicas capítulo 22.
And we're going to go down to verse 10.
Y vamos a ir al versículo 10.
And this is the prophetic word that we are releasing over this house.
Y esta es la palabra profética que vamos a desatar sobre esta casa.
And if you got your Bible,
y si tienes tu Biblia,
First Chronicles 22.
Primera de Crónicas 22.
It says, he shall build a house for my name, and he shall be my son, and I will be his father, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom over Israel forever.
Dice, él edificará una casa a mi nombre, será para mí un hijo y yo seré para él un padre, y afirmaré el trono de su reino sobre Israel para siempre.
Verse 12, only may the Lord give you wisdom and understanding. Everyone say with me, wisdom and understanding.
Y entendimiento.
And give you charge concerning Israel that you may keep the law of the Lord your God.
Versículo 12, que Jehová te dé entendimiento y prudencia para que cuando gobiernes a Israel guardes la ley de Jehová tu Dios.
Verse 15.
Versículo 15.
Moreover, there are workmen with you in abundance, woodsmen and stonecutters, all type of skillful men for every kind of work.
Tienes contigo muchos obreros, canteros, albañiles, carpinteros, hombres expertos en toda clase de obra.
And verse 16, of gold and silver and bronze and iron, there, can y'all preach with me tonight? There is no limit. Can y'all prophesy that a little bit louder? There is no limit. Come on, baby.
Versículo 16, del oro, de la plata, del bronce y del hierro hay en abundancia. O en inglés dice, no hay límite.
Arise and begin working and the Lord will be with you.
Levántate y manos a la obra que Jehová está contigo.
In this year 2022,
en este año 2022,
we are prophesying over this house.
Estamos profetizando sobre esta casa.
And if it's going to be over this house,
y
then
si
this means
sobre esta casa, esto significa
it's also for your house.
También es para tu casa.
Someone say it's for my house.
Alguien diga, es para mi
and
casa.
The prophetic word for us is there is no limit.
Y la palabra profética para nosotros
someone
es,
shout
no
with me, there
limites.
Is no limit.
No hay limites.
Turn to your neighbor, look him in the eye and tell him there is no
diga
limit.
Tu vecino, no hay limites.
So we are prophesying over this year 2022.
Entonces estamos profetizando sobre este año 2022.
Limitless 2022.
2022 sin límites.
Limitless 2022.
2022 sin
can y'all prophesy? It's a limitless year.
Profeticen eso. Es un año
it's
sin
a limitless
limites.
Year.
Es un año sin límites.
And I believe that God is going to release more. Go with me to 1 Chronicles chapter 4.
Vayan conmigo a Primera de Crónicas capítulo 4.
Two verses.
Dos versículos.
Verse 9.
Versículo 9.
1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 9.
Primera de Crónicas capítulo 4.
This is going to be our context tonight.
Versículo 9, este va a ser el contexto.
Now Jabez was more honorable than his brothers. And his mother called him Jabez, saying, because I bore him in pain.
Jabez fue más ilustre que sus hermanos, al cual su madre llamó Jabez, diciendo, por cuanto lo di a luz con dolor.
Verse 10, and Jabez called on the Lord God of Israel, saying, oh, that you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory.
Versículo 10, invocó Jabez al Dios de Israel diciendo, te ruego que me des tu bendición.
That you would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory.
Que ensanches mi territorio.
And that your hand would be with me.
Y que tu mano esté conmigo.
And that you would keep me from evil.
Y que me libres del mal.
That I may not cause pain.
Para que no me dañe.
And here we go, y'all. Receive this. And God granted him what he requested.
Reciban esto, dice, y le otorgó Dios lo que le pidió.
And God granted him what he requested.
Y le otorgó Dios lo que pidió.
Father, we bless your words tonight.
Padre, bendecimos tu palabra
esta noche. We open up our hearts.
Abrimos nuestros corazones.
We open up our minds.
Nuestras mentes.
And our spirit is receptive.
Y nuestro espíritu está receptivo.
No one came to hear me.
Nadie vino a escucharme.
We all came to hear you.
Todos vinimos a escucharte.
So we make you the guest of honor in this house tonight.
Entonces te hacemos el invitado.
El invitado hoy en esta noche.
En esta noche.
And Father, we honor you.
Y te honramos.
And we thank you.
Y te damos gracias.
Because you are so good to us.
Porque tú eres tan bueno con nosotros.
So we ask that you speak.
Entonces te pedimos que hables.
For your servants are listening
porque
tonight.
Porque tus siervos están escuchando
en Jesus'
esta noche.
Name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Everyone, put your hands together and give applause to the King of
Pongan
Kings
sus manos
tonight.
Juntas y dale un aplauso al Rey de Reyes.
Y'all may be seated.
Pueden tomar su lugar.
Tonight.
En esta noche,
we are launching and beginning a series called Limitless.
Estamos empezando una nueva serie llamada Sin Límites.
Everyone say Limitless.
Digan sin límites.
And as we prophesy this word,
y mientras profetizamos esta palabra,
tonight,
en esta noche,
out of the context of Jabez,
desde el contexto de Jabez,
I want to talk to you on labels,
quiero hablar sobre
lids and limits.
Tapas
y límites.
Y límites.
Nombres or
etiquetas.
Lids,
labels,
and limits.
Tapas y límites.
There are three things that God wants to do in our lives beginning tonight.
Hay tres cosas que Dios quiere hacer en nuestras vidas comenzando
and
en esta noche.
It begins with breaking off every label that the world has tried to put on your life.
Y se trata de romper cada etiqueta que el mundo quiso poner sobre tu
break
vida.
Break every label.
Quita cualquier etiqueta
that family has tried to put on your life.
Que tu familia ha tratado de poner sobre
and
tu vida.
And to break every label
y romper toda etiqueta
that your mistakes have tried to put over your life.
Que tus fracasos han tratado de poner sobre tu vida.
And so tonight,
entonces en esta noche,
we're taking this context out of Jabez.
Estamos sacando este contexto de la historia de Jabez.
We're asking the Holy Spirit to break every label.
Y estamos pidiéndole al Espíritu Santo que rompa toda etiqueta, toda tapa y toda limitación.
Someone say, I receive.
Alguien diga, yo lo recibo.
When we look at this story of Jabez,
cuando miramos la historia de Jabez,
it is so interesting,
es muy interesante
how God strategically puts his story,
como Dios estratégicamente pone la historia
within the context of 1 Chronicles chapter 4.
En el contexto de Primera de Crónicas capítulo 4.
And it's so crazy to me, y'all.
Y es muy loco para mí.
How Jabez's story was so important.
Como la historia de Jabez era muy importante.
So significant.
Y tan significante.
That God only used two verses to talk about it.
Que Dios solamente usó dos versículos para hablar de él.
And he talks about Jabez.
Y habla de Jabez.
In two verses.
En dos versículos.
And that's the only context we ever get of him.
Y es el único contexto que recibimos de él.
We don't know too much of his story.
No sabemos mucho de su historia.
But let's talk about what we do know.
Pero vamos a hablar de lo que sí sabemos.
In 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 9.
En Primera de Crónicas capítulo 4 versículo 9.
It says, now Jabez was more honorable than his brothers.
Dice aquí que Jabez fue más importante que sus hermanos.
Jabez was more honorable than his brothers.
Él fue más importante que sus hermanos.
So one of the things that we do know.
Entonces, una de las cosas que sí sabemos
is that Jabez had brothers.
Es que Jabez tenía hermanos.
He had a family.
Él tenía una familia.
But the Bible says that he was more honorable.
Pero la Biblia dice que él fue más importante.
When we talk about honor,
cuando hablamos de honor,
we are talking about the value that heaven has over your life.
Estamos hablando del valor que el cielo tiene sobre tu vida.
And I believe we're in a time and in a season tonight.
Y creo que estamos en un tiempo y una temporada en esta noche.
Where the Lord is demanding of us,
que el Señor está demandando de nosotros
more honor,
más honra.
We live in a dishonorable generation.
Vivimos en una generación que no sabe honrar.
We live in a generation that does not know honor.
Vivimos en una generación que no sabe cómo honrar.
Because when you speak about honor,
porque cuando uno habla del honor,
when I honor someone,
cuando yo honro a alguien,
what I am doing is putting on heaven's value over their lives.
Lo que yo estoy haciendo es poniendo el valor de los cielos sobre esa vida.
When you dishonor someone,
cuando tú deshonras a alguien,
it's because you don't recognize the value that heaven has over their lives.
Es porque tú no reconoces el valor que los cielos tienen sobre sus vidas.
When you dishonor someone,
cuando tú no honras a alguien,
what you are saying is that I don't recognize the God value in you.
Lo que tú estás diciendo es que yo no reconozco el valor de Dios en ti.
That's why when we worship,
por eso es cuando adoramos.
Worship is honor.
La adoración es honrar.
When you lift up your hands,
cuando tú levantas tus manos.
When you praise,
cuando tú adoras.
When you worship,
cuando tú adoras.
That is your form of honor.
Esa es tu forma de honrar.
If someone of importance were to walk into this room,
si alguien de importancia entrara a este lugar,
no matter who they are,
no importa quién son,
but if they are in any rank in the natural,
pero si en lo natural están en cualquier rango,
like when you go to a courthouse,
así como cuando tú entras a una casa de corte,
they tell you, everybody please rise,
todos te dicen por favor,
for
pónganse
the
de pie,
honorable judge so and so has walked into the room.
Porque el juez honorable fulanito ha entrado al.
And in comes the judge and everybody has to stand.
Y entra el juez y todos se tienen que poner de pie.
Because we honor someone of high rank or someone of importance.
Porque nosotros honramos a alguien con un alto rango.
So when you worship,
entonces cuando tú adoras,
worship is your expression of honor.
La adoración es tu expresión del honor.
You're saying, God, you're in this room, so I honor you.
Lo que tú estás diciendo es, Dios, tú estás en este lugar, entonces te honro.
I worship you as if you're in this room.
Yo te adoro como si tú estuvieras en este lugar.
Because I recognize who you are.
Porque yo reconozco quién tú eres.
And I recognize the value that you have in my life.
Y reconozco el valor que tú tienes en mi vida.
But hear me, if you don't value God,
pero escuchen, si tú no valoras a Dios,
you will never value the God in someone else.
Tú nunca vas a valorar el Dios en alguien más.
It's so important that we capture this in our heart tonight.
Es tan importante que nosotros capturemos esto en nuestro corazón
because
en esta
honor
noche, porque honor
is what will attract things towards your life.
Es lo que atrae las cosas hacia ti.
When you honor someone,
cuando tú honras a alguien,
they are attracted to your honor.
Están atraídos por tu honra.
But when you dishonor,
pero cuando tú deshonras,
what you dishonor will flee away from your life.
Lo que tú deshonras se quitará de tu vida.
Honor,
el honor
is an access. It's wisdom, y'all.
Es sabiduría, es acceso.
If young people can capture this tonight, I'm saving you years of delay.
Si tú, los jóvenes pueden captar esto, les estoy guardando años de retraso.
Because when you learn to honor,
porque cuando tú aprendes a honrar,
you are placing the highest value that heaven has over someone's life.
Tú estás poniendo ese valor más alto que los cielos tienen sobre la vida de alguien.
Honor is a code of conduct.
El honor es un código de conducta.
It's a position of your heart.
Es una posición de tu corazón.
It's a commitment of your attitude.
Es un compromiso de tu actitud.
Of atmosphere.
De atmósfera.
Of your posture, heart posture.
Es una postura de corazón.
Honor is the foundation for every godly relationship and covenant in your life.
Honor es el fundamento de cualquier relación de Dios y de pacto en tu vida.
You want to know why marriages get divided?
¿Quieren saber por qué los matrimonios se dividen?
You want to know why relationships get cut off?
¿Quieren saber por qué las relaciones se rompen?
It's because dishonor entered the relationship.
Es porque la falta de honor sucedió en la relación.
You forgot that the helpmate is to be honored.
Se te olvidó que la ayuda tienes que honrarlo.
When I honor my wife,
cuando yo honro a mi esposa,
and when my wife honors her husband,
y cuando mi esposa honra a su esposo,
what we are doing is placing heaven's value over their lives.
Lo que estamos haciendo es poniendo el valor de los cielos sobre sus vidas.
And when we dishonor one another,
y cuando nos falta el honor al uno al otro,
it creates an open door or a gate, a breach for the enemy to enter.
Crea una puerta abierta para que el enemigo entre.
Because the first thing that Satan did in the heavens,
porque lo primero que el Satanás hizo en los cielos,
was dishonor the position of God in the heavens.
Fue deshonrar la posición de Dios en los cielos.
And when you dishonor something,
y cuando tú no honras algo,
anyone that dishonors,
cualquier persona que deshonra,
will make things separate from them.
Hace que las cosas se separen de ellos.
In relationships and marriage,
en las relaciones y en matrimonios,
the enemy is in charge of instilling dishonor in relationships.
El enemigo está encargado de poner la deshonra en las relaciones.
Because if he can put a seed of dishonor,
porque si él puede poner una semilla de deshonra,
it will create chaos in a marriage and in a family.
Va a crear caos en un matrimonio y en una familia.
Ephesians says, "Men,
el Efesios dice, hombre,
love your wives.
Ama tu esposa."
But then it says, "Women,
y luego dice, esposas,
honor your husbands." Because honor will do something for you.
Porque el honor hace algo por ti.
Honor is a heart posture.
El honor es una postura de corazón.
But honor is to be exercised.
Pero el honor se tiene que ejercitar.
We in this generation need to learn to exercise honor.
Nosotros en esta generación tenemos que aprender a ejecutar honor.
Honor is how you think.
El honor es como tú piensas.
Everyone say with me, honor.
Todos digan conmigo, el honor
is how I think.
Es como yo pienso.
Honor,
el honor
is what you do.
Es lo que tú haces.
Say with me, honor.
Digan honor
is what I do.
Es lo que yo hago.
But honor,
pero honor
is also in what you say.
También se trata en lo que tú dices.
Everyone say honor.
Digan honor.
Is in what I say.
Es lo que yo digo.
When we talk about honor,
cuando hablamos de la honra,
there's 100-fold, 60-fold, and 30-fold.
Hay 160 y 30.
There is honor is in how you think.
Hay honra en cómo tú piensas.
You honor in what you do.
Tú honras con lo que tú haces.
And you honor in what you say.
Y tú honras con lo que tú dices.
When it says that Jabez had brothers,
cuando dice que Jabez tenía hermanos,
but he was more honorable,
pero él fue más honorable,
it means that he understood heaven's value.
Es significa que él entendió el valor de los cielos.
He understood heaven's value in his life.
Él entendió el valor de los cielos sobre su vida.
And he understood the value that God had in his life.
Y él entendió el valor que Dios tenía en su vida.
Not only was he honorable,
no solamente era honorable,
but he was also honored, sorry.
Él también honraba.
And he would honor.
Él también honraba.
And this is why Jesus said,
y por eso Jesús dijo,
these people honor me with their lips,
esta gente me honra con sus labios,
but their heart is far from me.
Pero sus corazones están lejos
because
de
people
mí.
Will honor you with their mouth,
porque la gente te va a honrar con sus labios,
but they'll slander you with their heart.
Pero te van a rechazar con su corazón.
That's why your honor is a heart posture.
Por eso tu honra es una postura de corazón.
Everyone say, I got it.
Todos digan, lo entiendo.
In this season, we must learn to honor.
En esta temporada tenemos que aprender a honrar.
You learn to honor your pastors.
Cuando tú aprendes a honrar a tus pastores,
there's a blessing that comes with that honor.
Hay una bendición que viene con esa honra.
When you reckon, I learned this as a kid.
Lo aprendí desde niño.
And I taught some kids.
Y yo aprendí a algunos
when I used to youth pastor.
Cuando yo era un pastor de jóvenes.
And tonight,
y en esta noche,
I have one of the kids.
Yo tengo uno de los jóvenes
that used to call me his pastor.
Que me llamaba su
sitting
pastor,
right here, and his name is Joshua Sice.
Aquí sentado y su nombre es Josh.
Let's give it up for Joshua.
Vamos a darle para Josh.
And Josh,
y Josh,
a few months ago,
hace unos meses,
we happened to be in Uvalde,
estábamos en Uvalde,
which is my hometown,
que es donde yo vengo,
and we were going into Walmart,
y entramos a Walmart,
and Josh walks out.
Y llega Josh.
And I remember having a conversation with Josh.
Y yo tuve una conversación con él.
How old are you now, Josh? Oh my gosh. He's 24 years old, and he looks like he's still 16. How does that happen?
Todavía parece de 16.
24 years old.
24.
And I've known him since he was a kid.
Y lo he conocido desde niño.
And he was part of my youth group.
Y era parte de mi grupo de jóvenes.
When I was in Uvalde.
Cuando yo estaba en Uvalde.
And when our youth just exploded.
Y cuando nuestros jóvenes explotaron.
We had a massive explosion of young people.
Tuvimos una explosión de jóvenes.
Where we went from having about 6 young people.
Donde teníamos 6 jóvenes.
And within 90 days we were over 300.
Y dentro de 90 días teníamos más de 300.
It was so incredible what God was doing in Uvalde.
Era tan increíble lo que Dios estaba haciendo en Uvalde.
That through that student movement.
Que a través de ese movimiento.
We were having 5 a.m. prayers.
Teníamos oraciones de 5 en la mañana.
He knows what 5 a.m. prayers is like.
Él sabe lo que es tener oraciones a las 5 de la mañana.
How we train them.
Porque así los entrenamos a ellos.
We would train young people how to hear the voice of God at a young age.
Cuando tú entrenas los jóvenes a escuchar la voz de Dios en una temprana edad.
Revive Church is just stepping into what we used to do early on.
Iglesia, esta iglesia está entrando a lo que antes hacíamos.
And we would train young people to hear the voice of God.
Y entrenábamos a jóvenes a escuchar la voz de Dios.
At 5 a.m.
A las 5 de la mañana.
And after 5 a.m. prayer.
Y después de las 5 de la mañana.
We would drive to school.
Manejábamos a la escuela.
And then we would pray on campus at the high school.
Y luego orábamos en la escuela.
And I just remember being surrounded by young people all the time.
Y me acuerdo estaba yo rodeado de jóvenes.
But one of the most beautiful things.
Pero una de las cosas más hermosas.
Is that when I spoke with Josh that day at Walmart.
Es que cuando yo hablé con Josh ese día.
Is that even years later he still learned the value of honor.
Después de tantos años, él entendió el valor del honor.
And he just said, Pastor, I just want to go to San Antonio.
Y él dijo, solamente quiero ir a San Antonio,
Pastor. I just want to sit there at your church service.
Y quiero sentarme allí al servicio.
And I didn't know that Josh was going to bring a whole crew.
Y yo no sabía que él
How many of y'all are all from Uvalde?
Una banda.
Raise your hand. Look at that. Come on, let's give it up for all these students, y'all. And when I saw him walking in, I was like, yo, Josh, what's up? He's like, oh, I brought all of them. And I was like, what?
Y cuando él entró, le dije, ¿cómo estás? Y dijo, yo traje todos ellos.
Because honor was always a heart posture.
Porque el honor siempre es una postura de corazón.
Honor is something that is birthed out of the heart.
El honor es algo que sale del corazón.
And even though we can honor with our lips.
Y aunque podemos honrar con nuestros labios.
You must learn to honor with your heart.
Tienes que aprender a honrar con tu corazón.
And Jabez was a more honorable person.
Y Jabez fue un hombre honorable.
But watch what happens in verse number 9.
Mira, pero mira lo que sucede en versículo 9.
The Bible says.
La Biblia dice.
That even though he was more honorable, if y'all can put it on the screen for me.
Que aunque él era más honorable.
In verse number 9 it says his mother.
Dice que su madre
called him Jabez,
le puso Jabez,
because I bore him in pain.
Porque dice, con aflicción lo he dado a luz.
Now I want you to capture this tonight.
Quiero que capturen esto en esta noche.
Because there is an issue here.
Porque aquí hay un problema.
That even though Jabez,
que aunque Jabez
was more honorable,
era más honorable,
he knew heaven's value.
Él sabía el valor de los cielos.
His mother,
su madre,
did not put heaven's value on him.
No puso el valor de los cielos sobre él.
His mother,
su madre,
decided to put pain over his life.
Decidió poner dolor sobre su vida.
His mother,
su madre,
decided to put her experience.
Decidió poner su
over her son's life.
Sobre la vida de su hijo.
Her trauma,
su trauma,
over his life.
Sobre la vida de su hijo.
Her pain,
su dolor,
over his future.
Sobre el futuro.
And now every time Jabez says his name,
y entonces cada vez que Jabez dice su nombre,
Jabez,
Jabez,
here comes pain. Come on.
Mira, aquí viene el dolor.
Here comes pain.
Aquí viene el dolor.
And the truth is this, church.
Y la verdad es esta.
How many times?
¿Cuántas veces?
Have people tried to put a label on our name
han tratado de poner una etiqueta sobre
because
nuestro
of their trauma and their pain.
Por su dolor y su trauma.
It is I almost cussed or something. I don't know what was I don't know what I was going to say right there, but it felt like a cuss word wanted to come out.
No sé lo que iba a decir ahí.
Y'all felt that? Y'all felt now y'all woke up, right?
Ahora se despertaron, ¿verdad?
Pastor about to cuss in the church.
Oh, el pastor va a hacer maldecir.
It is a disgrace.
Es una desgracia.
There we go. That's a good word, right? When you look at your children,
cuando tú ves a tus hijos,
and you begin to put labels on them,
y empiezas a poner etiquetas sobre
because
ellos,
of your past and your trauma,
por tu pasado y tu trauma,
it is an error in the spirit.
Es un error en el espíritu.
When you begin to look at your children,
cuando comienzas a ver tus hijos,
and you put a label on them,
y tú pones una etiqueta
because
sobre
of
ellos,
your past and your experience,
por tu pasado y tu experiencia.
And the truth is this,
y la verdad es esta,
God,
Dios,
did not give you that label.
No te dio esa etiqueta.
I don't know what label that could have been.
Yo no sé qué etiqueta podría ser.
But I know some of your stories in this room.
Pero yo conozco algunas de sus historias en este lugar.
And a label is as simple as calling you a loser.
Y una etiqueta es simplemente poder decir la palabra eres un perdedor.
Calling you a victim.
Diciéndote eres un víctima.
Calling you broke.
Eres pobre.
Calling you an addict.
Diciéndote eres un adicto.
Calling you an orphan.
Eres un huérfano.
Calling you empty.
Eres, estás vacío.
You're good for nothing.
Eres bueno para nada.
Why are you even here?
¿Por qué estás aquí?
All those words,
todas esas palabras,
begin to put labels over your life.
Comienzan a poner etiquetas sobre tu vida.
And it's almost as if you walk around,
y es como si tú caminaras por todos lados,
trying to live out something because of somebody else's trauma.
Tratando de vivir algo a causa de la trauma de alguien más.
And God comes and says, you're more than conqueror.
Y Dios viene y dice, tú eres más que vencedor.
God comes and says, you're blessed and highly favored.
Y él dice, tú eres bendecido.
God says, you're the head and not the tail.
Y él dice, tú eres la cabeza y no la
God
cola.
Says, you're above and not beneath.
Tú estás arriba y tú no estás
God
abajo.
Says, you will live in abundance and never in famine.
Dios dice, tú vivirás en abundancia y nunca en escasez.
But because of somebody else's label.
Pero a causa de las etiquetas de alguien más.
Because of their pain.
A causa de su dolor.
I chose to put it on you.
Yo decidí ponerlo en ti.
How many times haven't we put our past experience on someone else?
¿Cuántas veces no hemos puesto nuestras experiencias del pasado en alguien más?
Because you can't own up to your own trauma.
Porque tú no puedes tomar responsabilidad de tu trauma.
Because you can't own up to your own pain.
Porque tú no puedes enfrentar tus dolores.
Because you can't own up to your own stuff.
Porque tú no puedes enfrentar tus propios problemas.
And this will only happen to your children.
Y esto solamente sucederá a tus niños.
But this will happen to your spouse.
Pero también sucederá a tu esposo.
This will happen in your relationships.
También sucederá en tus relaciones.
And you start living life as if people owe you something.
Y empiezas a vivir la vida como si la gente te debe algo.
You start living life entitled as if people owe you something.
Y empiezas a vivir como si la gente te debe algo.
And the truth is, it was your pain and your trauma.
Y la verdad es, fue tu dolor y tu trauma.
But God did not give that to you.
Pero Dios no te dio eso.
Someone say with me, God did not give
Alguien
me
diga
that.
Conmigo, Dios no me dio eso.
Because according to his word, you are a son and a daughter of a king.
Porque de acuerdo a la palabra, tú eres un hijo del un
Someone
rey.
Someone shout with me like you believe it. I'm a son.
Alguien dígalo como si lo crees.
And I'm a
soy
daughter
hijo,
of a king.
Y
Come
yo
on.
Soy hija de un
if
rey.
You're a son, say, I'm a son.
Si tú eres hijo,
but
yo
shout
soy
it like
hijo.
You mean it, man.
Pero
I'm a son.
Como si lo crees. Yo soy
Ladies,
un hijo.
Shout it. I'm a daughter.
Y mujeres griten, yo
I'm
soy
a daughter
una hija,
of a king.
Una hija de un rey.
So it doesn't matter what you've been through.
Entonces no importa lo que tú has pasado.
It doesn't matter how you entered
no
into this
importa
earth.
Cómo tú entraste a esta
well,
tierra.
Pastor, if you knew my story.
Ay, pastor, si supieras mi historia.
If you knew the abuse I went through.
Si supieras el abuso que yo pasé.
If you knew the pain I went through.
Si supieras
it
cómo
doesn't matter how you came in.
No importa cómo tú entraste.
What matters is how you come out.
Lo que importa es cómo tú sales.
You could have come in through abuse and neglect and bitterness and resentment.
A lo mejor entraste con abuso en rechazo.
But it's how you choose to turn those things around.
Pero decides cómo cambiar eso, se trata
allow
de
God
eso.
To be God in your life.
Y permitas Dios que sea Dios en tu
Because
vida.
Everything that the enemy meant for evil,
porque todo lo que el enemigo trató para mal,
he'll turn it around for your good.
Dios lo va a voltear para tu bien.
For your good.
Para tu bien.
Someone say it was for my good.
Alguien diga era para
Just
mi
say
bien.
It was for my good.
Era para mi bien.
But this is what I don't want you to do.
Pero esto es lo que yo no quiero que tú hagas.
I don't want you to start putting labels on your marriage.
No quiero que pongas etiquetas en tu matrimonio.
Labels on your children.
Etiquetas en tus hijos.
Labels on your
en tus relaciones,
because there's some of y'all
porque hay algunos de ustedes
that even have labeled your own pastor
que también han etiquetado tu pastor
because of what your old pastor did to you.
Por lo que tu viejo pastor te hizo.
Why do I have to live subject to an experience that you went through?
Porque yo tengo que vivir sujeto a una experiencia que tú viviste
and be labeled because of your trauma
y ser etiquetado a causa de tu trauma,
your pain,
tu dolor,
your hurt,
tu dolor,
not that I did.
Nada que yo hice,
that someone else did.
Pero alguien más te hizo.
I just have a problem with pastors.
Ay, yo tengo un problema con los pastores.
Because they just want my money.
Porque quieren mi dinero.
Say it right now, I don't need your money.
Te digo ahorita, no necesito tu dinero.
But I do need your heart.
Pero sí necesito tu corazón.
Because I can't pastor you if I don't have your heart.
Porque no te puedo pastorear si no tengo tu corazón.
It's not just, hey Bert, what's going on?
No se trata de solamente Humberto, ¿cómo
hey, Humberto,
estás? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué onda, Humberto?
Because if you recognize me only in the natural,
porque si solamente me reconoces en lo natural,
you only get the blessing of the natural.
Solamente vas a recibir la bendición de
and
lo natural.
Guess what? I got nothing to give you.
Y sabes qué, no tengo nada que darte.
But when you call me pastor,
pero cuando tú me dices pastor,
it's not about the title.
No se trata del título.
It's that you recognize heaven's value over my life.
Es que tú reconoces el valor de los cielos sobre mi vida.
Are you understanding what I'm saying?
¿Están entendiendo lo que estoy diciendo?
When you look at your the pastor's wife.
Cuando tú ves a la esposa del pastor,
you call her pastor.
Tú le dices pastora.
Not because we need the title.
No porque necesitamos el título.
It doesn't make us anything.
No nos hace nada.
As a matter of fact, it scares me every time.
De hecho, me asusta cada vez.
Because I don't want it.
Porque no lo quiero.
But God called me to it.
Pero Dios me llamó a
so
eso.
When you look at her,
entonces cuando la miren
say,
a ella,
hey, Pastor Leslie.
Dicen pastora Leslie.
You are putting heaven's value over her life.
Están poniendo el valor de los cielos sobre su vida.
Pastor Humberto, heaven's value over my life.
Pastor Humberto, el valor de los cielos sobre su vida.
And what that does for you.
Y lo que eso hace para ti.
Is that it attracts things towards you.
Eso atrae cosas hacia ti.
And it attracts heaven's value towards you.
Y atrae el valor de los cielos a ti.
But when you don't even honor God,
pero si tú no honras a Dios,
you won't ever honor a man or a woman.
Tú nunca vas a honrar una hombre, un hombre, una mujer.
Because if you can't see when God walks into the room,
porque cuando tú no ves cuando Dios entra a un lugar,
you won't see when the God in us walk into the room.
Tú no vas a ver cuando el Dios en nosotros entra a un lugar.
Are y'all catching this?
Están captando esto.
I'm trying to help. Are the body of Christ.
Estoy tratando de ayudar el cuerpo de Cristo.
Because we have a missing link of honor.
Porque tenemos un, algo que falta, que
we're
es
so
el honor.
Good about talking to everyone. We're so good about talking bad about everyone else.
Estamos, somos buenos en hablar mal de todos los demás.
Your old church, your old people.
De iglesias pasados, gente del pasado. Tu pastor.
You talk about bad about everyone else.
Puedes hablar mal de todos.
But when we talk about honor,
pero cuando hablamos de honor,
you're learning to put heaven's value over someone's life.
Estás aprendiendo a poner el valor de los cielos sobre la vida de alguien. Y la verdad es esta.
Jabez's mother did not put heaven's value over his.
La mamá de Jabez no puso el valor de los cielos sobre él.
Rather than putting heaven's value over his life,
en vez de poner el valor de los cielos sobre su vida,
she put her pain and her experience over his life.
Ella puso su experiencia, su dolor sobre su vida.
Bible talks about.
La Biblia habla.
When a woman has a baby,
que cuando una mujer tiene un bebé,
and she delivers that child,
y ella da luz a ese bebé,
all the pain that she went through,
todo el dolor que ella pasó,
suddenly just goes away.
De repente se desaparece.
The moment that child comes out of the womb,
el momento que ese bebé sale a la luz,
and the pain that it took to deliver that child,
y ese dolor que se tuvo para dar a luz a ese bebé,
just this miracle that just happens, almost like poof, it's gone.
Es como si de repente ya no hay dolor.
Because when they're delivering.
Porque cuando están dando a luz,
I remember my wife with Micah specifically, our first son.
Yo me acuerdo con mi esposa con el primer hijo.
Our first child.
Mi primer hijo.
My wife spoke in other tongues.
Mi esposa habló en lenguas.
She spoke in a tongue that I've never heard her speak.
Ella habló en lenguas que yo nunca.
It almost seems like she was being delivered.
Como si la estaban liberando.
Because she said, "Get over here." I don't know what was happening.
Yo no sé qué pasó.
And something begins to come out.
Y algo empieza a salir.
So I remember going to the hospital about 8:30 at night.
Y yo me acuerdo yendo al hospital a las 8:30 de la noche.
And it was a 24-hour delivery, y'all.
Y era como de 24 horas.
It was 8:30 the next day, p.m.
Era a las 8:30 de la próxima noche.
The little boy finally decided to pop out his head.
Y este niño al fin decidió salir.
And it was horrible.
Y fue horrible.
I can't even tell you. I didn't even deliver the kid and it was horrible.
Y yo no di a luz a ese bebé, pero fue horrible.
I'm like, oh my gosh.
Y dije, wow.
Don't the doctors know when the baby should be coming out? Come on, they should at least give you a heads up.
Doctores no saben cuándo va a salir el bebé o qué.
Why do you want me here a day before?
Porque me quieren aquí el día antes.
We hadn't eaten.
No habíamos comido.
We hadn't slept.
No habíamos dormido.
They're coming in the room every 2 hours.
Entraban cada dos horas.
It's horrible.
Es horrible.
But as soon as that kid was born.
Pero cuando sale ese bebé,
and it's like, wah!
Y sale ese lloro.
Suddenly the process,
de repente el proceso,
the pain of the process,
el dolor del proceso,
suddenly just flees out the room.
De repente sale del lugar.
And the joy of the delivery,
y el gozo de ese parto,
just suddenly fills your heart.
De repente llena tu corazón.
Any parents that can testify to that?
Hay algunos padres que pueden testificar.
Any moms
eso?
That can testify? Yeah,
algunas
yeah, it was
mamás.
Worth it. It was worth.
Vale la pena.
We had the second one.
Y luego el segundo.
And it was so easy for her. She's like, I want another one. I'm like, Jesus, y'all pray for her. Stretch your hands.
Fue tan fácil. Ella dijo, yo quiero otro.
The truth is this.
La verdad es esto.
Jabez's mother.
La mamá de Jabez.
She did not allow the joy of her delivery.
No permitió el gozo de su parto.
To overtake the pain of the process.
Que sobretomara el dolor del proceso.
How many of you have not allowed the joy of your victory?
¿Cuántos de ustedes no han permitido el gozo de tu victoria?
The fact that God saved your marriage.
El hecho que Dios salvó tu matrimonio.
The fact that God saved your business.
El hecho que Dios
I wish I had some people that
negocio.
Could preach with you. The fact that you're still here is the very fact that God is still good.
El hecho que tú estás aquí es el hecho que Dios es bueno.
The fact is you should have lost it.
El hecho es que tú lo hubieras
the
perdido.
Fact is you should have ran.
Tú hubieras corrido.
But don't allow the joy of the victory.
Pero no permitas el gozo de la victoria.
To be overtaken by the pain of the process.
Que se sobretome por el dolor del proceso.
Because then you begin to label your future according to the pain of the past.
Porque luego empiezas a poner etiquetas con el dolor de tu pasado.
Pastor, I didn't know it was going to be this hard.
Ay, pastor, yo no sabía que iba a ser tan difícil.
Well, I didn't know either.
Yo no sabía tampoco.
I didn't know you were going to be that hard.
Yo no sabía que tú ibas a ser tan difícil.
Jeez. But guess what, y'all?
Pero ¿saben qué?
The joy of the victory.
El gozo de la victoria.
The joy of the victory.
El gozo de la victoria.
Put the joy set before me, Jesus said.
El gozo que estaba delante
de él. The joy set before me.
El gozo que está delante de nosotros.
He endured the cross.
Él enfrentó la cruz.
All the way unto death.
Hasta la muerte.
I want us tonight.
Quiero que en esta noche.
To stop labeling.
Que paremos de etiquetar.
Your future.
Nuestros futuros
on the pain of the process.
Con el dolor del
proceso. Does anybody receive this tonight?
¿Hay alguien recibiendo
esto? Does anybody
esto?
Receive this tonight?
¿Hay alguien recibiendo
because
esto?
The Spirit of the Lord spoke to me.
Porque el Espíritu del Señor me
and
habló.
He says, in this year 2022,
y él dijo, en este año 2022,
I'm removing the labels
estoy removiendo las etiquetas
over people's lives,
sobre las vidas,
over their marriages,
sobre sus matrimonios,
over their children,
sobre sus hijos,
over their families,
sobre sus familias.
Hear me, y'all.
Escúchenme.
The Lord is going to break the generational labels that God, that
el Señor
that the enemy tried to put over your life.
Las etiquetas generacionales.
Someone shout, I'm not broke. I'm not a loser.
No soy un perdedor.
I'm not a victim.
No soy una víctima.
I'm not an orphan.
No soy un huérfano.
I'm not empty.
No estoy vacío.
I'm not unwanted.
No estoy.
I'm not worthless.
No soy.
I'm not a failure.
No es que valor.
But I'm blessed
no
and highly
ofendido,
favored. Come on,
bendecido.
Prophesy. I'm blessed and highly favored.
Estoy bendecido.
I am the head and not the tail.
Soy la cabeza y no la
cola. I'm more than a conqueror.
Voy a ir a
conquistar. I'm more than victorious.
Voy a ser victorioso.
I will live in abundance and never in famine.
Viviré en abundancia y nunca en escasez.
Everything shall go good with
todo
me.
Será bueno.
Goodness and mercy follow me
su
all the days
y
of my
misericordia
life.
Me seguirán
everything
todos
my hand touches shall be
todo
blessed.
Lo que mi mano toque
every place my foot tread upon shall be mine.
Que mi pie pise será
I
bendecido.
Got a blessing over my life.
Yo tengo una bendición sobre mi vida.
I'm anointed.
Estoy ungido.
I'm blessed.
Estoy bendecido.
I'm appointed.
Estoy bendecido.
Come on, church, y'all got to catch this tonight.
Vamos.
Am I talking to anybody
estoy
here tonight?
A alguien en esta noche?
For the next 10 seconds, can you just give God a shout of praise as if you believe it?
Segundos, un grito
like if
a
the
Dios
devil lost with your life.
Porque el enemigo perdió con tu vida.
Like if nothing's going to stop you.
Nada te va a parar.
As if nothing's going to hinder
así como si nada te va a impedir.
I'm not the labels of my past.
No soy las etiquetas de mi pasado.
I'm not the labels of my process.
No soy las etiquetas de mi proceso.
I will live in the victory.
Viviré en victoria.
I will live in the joy of the victory.
Viviré en el gozo de la victoria.
Someone just look at your neighbor and tell them, ha, ha, ha.
Digan, ve a tu vecino y dile, ha,
ha, ha. Just don't breathe too much on their face.
Solamente no respires tanto en su cara.
Can y'all just laugh for a little bit?
¿Se pueden reír por un momento?
Can y'all laugh?
Se pueden reír por un momento.
Can y'all laugh? Come on.
Se pueden reír, vamos.
I pray, I hear the Spirit of the Lord say right now.
Yo escucho el Espíritu del Señor decir.
I feel the Lord say, I'm about to put
siento el Señor decir, estoy a
punto mantle of joy
de poner un manto de gozo
over your house.
Sobre tu casa.
Over this house.
Sobre esta casa.
And it's over your house.
Y también está sobre tu
someone
casa.
Say, mantle of joy.
Todos digan un manto
joy
de gozo.
In the morning.
Gozo en la mañana.
Although sorrow may come to the night.
Aunque
but joy comes
noche,
in the morning.
El gozo
I prophesy that in 24 hours somebody's about to step from sorrow into joy, from mourning into dancing.
Yo profetizo que en 24 horas habrá de luto a gozo. Algo cambiará en esas 24
you're
horas.
Not gonna be
porque no vas a estar
the label of your pain.
La etiqueta de tu pasado.
I refuse
yo rehuso
to allow you to live
que tú vivas
by the label of your past
por las etiquetas de
and
tu
by
pasado.
The label of your past. Is this for anybody
es
here
para
tonight?
Alguien en esta noche.
Jabez had to make a decision.
Jabez hizo una decisión.
Not to live by the label of his mom.
De no vivir de acuerdo con la etiqueta
because
de su madre.
Because you know what labels do?
Porque saben lo que hacen las etiquetas.
Labels put lids.
Porque las etiquetas ponen tapas.
A lid.
Una tapa.
Is like a ceiling.
Es como un
techo.
Un techo.
That the enemy tries to put on you.
Que el enemigo trata de poner sobre ti.
Because it creates resistance.
Porque eso crea resistencia.
For growth.
Para crecimiento.
Every lid.
Y cada tapa.
Is something that you put over a container.
Es algo que tú pones sobre un contenedor.
To keep the contents in.
Para que tú mantengas esos adentro.
And to keep other contents out.
Y para que tú puedas sacar otras cosas de ese contenedor.
So when they put a lid on something.
Entonces cuando ponen una tapa.
It's to keep things concealed.
Es para poner o mantener las cosas encerradas.
But God in this season.
Pero Dios en esta temporada.
Is about to reveal who you really are.
Está a punto de revelar quién tú verdaderamente eres.
Somebody's going to catch this tonight.
Alguien va a captar esto.
In this year 2022.
En este año 2022.
God is about to reveal your calling.
Dios está a punto de revelar tu
llamado. He's going to reveal your purpose.
Tu propósito.
He's going to reveal your assignment.
Él va a revelar tu asignación.
He's going to reveal what you were assigned for.
Él va a revelar que
what
a
you
que
were anointed for.
Para que fuiste ungido.
And hear me, just like Generation Z loves to say, no cap, baby, no
y así
cap.
Como la generación Z dice,
turn to your neighbor, no just cap. Tell them, no cap in 2022.
No hay tapas.
No cap. In 2022, I prophesy that every lid over your life, every generational lid over your life, everything that has started to stop you, hinder you, stop you from growth is coming off of your life in this season. Somebody say, I receive.
Digan, yo recibo.
Every lid comes off.
Toda tapa se quita
every
de tu
cap
vida.
Comes off.
Toda tapa se quita de su vida.
Every resistance.
Toda resistencia.
Every hindrance.
Todo impedimento.
Everything that has tried to stop you. I just heard the Lord say this.
Escuché el Señor decir esto.
The delay is over.
El
the delay is over.
Ya se terminó.
Everything that had tried to delay your life.
Cualquier cosa que trató de retrasarte
and delay
en tu
your
vida
purpose.
Y tu propósito.
And delay the destiny.
Y retrasar el destino.
It's coming to an end.
Se está a punto de
someone say it's over, it's over, it's over.
Alto. Todos digan, ya se terminó.
Hear me.
Escuchen.
The generational curses.
Las maldiciones generacionales.
The generational lids.
Las tapas generacionales.
The generational limits.
Las limitaciones generacionales.
It was going to continue.
Van a continuar.
It was going to continue.
Iban a continuar.
Until it met up with you.
Hasta que llegó a ti.
Someone say it ends with me.
Alguien diga se termina conmigo.
Someone prophesy over your lineage and say it ends with me. Come on, young people, just say it ends with me. Every generational curse ends with me. The addiction ends with me. The poverty ends with me.
La pobreza termina conmigo.
The depression ends with me.
La depresión termina
the anxiety
conmigo.
Ends with me.
La ansiedad termina
the sickness
conmigo.
And disease, it
la
ends with me.
Termina
the pain
conmigo.
And the hurt and the trauma, it ends with
el
me.
Dolor y la trauma termina conmigo.
It ends with my
termina
life.
Con mi vida.
Because from here it won't cross over.
Porque desde aquí no va a cruzar hacia
someone
adelante.
Say, I receive.
Alguien diga, yo recibo.
Y'all sit down, we're just talking, we're just talking.
Tomen su lugar, estamos hablando.
The Lord said,
el Señor dice,
every label,
toda etiqueta,
every lid,
toda tapa,
and every limitation,
y toda limitación,
is about to come off of your
se
life.
Va a quitar de tu vida.
Because in this year 2022,
porque en este año 2022,
it will be a year with no limits.
Será un año sin límites.
Limitations,
las limitaciones,
are those boundaries.
Y son esas
esas fronteras, those boundaries that define what belongs to you.
Esas fronteras que definen lo que te pertenece a ti.
It's like this is what you're limited to.
Es como si te dice aquí tú estás limitado.
Limitations are the boundaries.
Las limitaciones son esas fronteras.
That define who you are.
Esas barreras que definen quién tú
eres. And what you can be.
Y qué tú puedes hacer.
Limitations.
Las limitaciones.
Are the boundaries.
Son las barreras.
That tell you where you can and cannot go.
Que te dicen dónde tú puedes ir y que no dónde tú no puedes ir.
I know this is for someone right now.
Yo sé que esto es para alguien.
Y'all have ever been to a fancy restaurant?
¿Has ido a un restaurante lujoso?
I'm talking about like the big. What's the most expensive that one in Dallas you went to, Kyle? Chulox. Chulox. How much? $700.
Hay un restaurante en Dallas.
How many people? 4 people.
De 700 que era $700 por 4 personas.
You want to go out to eat? Go out to eat with him, all right?
Y si quieren salir a comer, salgan con él.
He has gift cards right now. Use them, Lord. But when y'all know when y'all go to a place.
Saben que cuando vas a un lugar.
And it's super bougie.
Y es muy lujoso.
And you're underdressed on top of that.
Y luego no estás vestido bien.
And you walk in.
Y entras.
And you're like, I don't belong here.
Y dices, yo no pertenezco
aquí. How do I even eat?
¿Qué voy a comer?
Why do I have two forks on my left and two knives on my right?
Porque tengo dos tenedores acá y dos
cuchillos acá. It's like that moment you pick up the spoon, you're like, what's this spoon for?
Y dices, juntas la cuchara y dices, ¿para qué es esto?
That type of fancy.
Ese tipo de lujo.
But you feel like you don't belong.
Donde tú dices, ay, yo no pertenezco aquí.
That's your limitation.
Esa es tu limitación.
That's your limitation.
Esa es tu limitación.
I can't go out there to the north side.
Ay, yo no puedo ir para allá al norte.
Because I'm from the south side.
Porque yo soy del sur.
And the west side vatos over here.
Y los de este acá.
We don't go up there.
Nosotros no vamos para allá.
Where do you live? Where do y'all live?
¿Dónde viven?
And as soon as you say, oh, Belverde area.
Cuando tú dices, ah, Belverde.
Ah.
Oh.
Never been up there.
Nunca he ido para allá.
I just stay on 410 in San Pedro, right?
Yo vivo ahí por 4 días y San Pedro.
But the truth is this.
Pero la verdad es esta.
It's your limitation.
Son tus limitaciones.
Some of y'all.
Algunos de ustedes.
Have to just start doing crazy stuff.
Tienen que empezar a hacer cosas locas.
Because when you ask God for a house.
Porque cuando tú le pidas a Dios por una casa.
It's just a little house, God.
Ay, solamente es una casita.
Just enough to get by for my family.
Para que nosotros podamos vivir yo y mi familia.
You say things like, I would be happy.
Tú dices, yo estaría feliz.
With just a 3-bedroom, 1-bathroom.
Una casa de 3 cuartos, un baño.
I would just be happy if I had a little thing.
Yo sería feliz si tuviera algo pequeño.
I know y'all don't know this revive.
Yo sé que ustedes no saben esto.
Not everybody knows this.
Y no todos saben esto.
But yesterday,
pero ayer,
we were able to give the keys.
Podíamos darle las llaves.
To a house.
De una casa.
To two very loving people in this church.
A dos personas muy amorosas de esta casa.
And that is Jesse and Lupe Garza.
Y los hermanos Garza.
Who oversee our kids department.
Que ellos sobreven el departamento de niños.
And yesterday,
y ayer,
I said, come check out your house.
Y les dije, vengan a ver su casa.
Brand new floors.
Pisos nuevos.
Carpet.
Todo nuevo.
Walls, everything's just beautiful.
Todo está hermoso.
I remember when they walked in.
Cuando ellos entraron.
And as soon as Sister Lupe walks in.
Y cuando entró la hermana
Lupe.
She looks
at her hardwood floors.
Ella ve los pisos.
She looks at her nice white cabinets.
Los gabinetes blancos.
Everything beautiful.
Todo hermoso.
She began to tear up.
Y empezó a llorar.
Brother Jesse always, he's always tearing up, look.
El hermano Jesse.
But afterwards, I said, what do you think?
Y les dije, ¿qué piensan?
She said, I just didn't believe God would give us something this big.
Y dijo, yo no pensé que Dios nos iba a dar algo tan grande.
5-bedroom house.
Una casa de 5 recámaras.
Downstairs, upstairs.
Arriba y abajo.
And yesterday, as a church.
Y ayer como iglesia.
We were able to get them into that house.
Podíamos ayudarles a entrar a esa casa.
And it was just a beautiful thing.
Y fue algo hermoso.
That's how you can test people's hearts when y'all start getting bitter because of their blessing, right?
Así es como tú pruebas los corazones cuando se empiezan a poner.
Well, pastor never gave me a house.
Ay, el pastor nunca me.
You never done that for me.
Me dio una casa a mí. Nunca has hecho eso para mí.
If you rejoice in their victory.
Si tú te regocijas en su victoria.
Something just happens in you. I was in there like, man, I wish this was my house.
Yo quisiera que eso fuera mi casa.
I'm there painting the whole house.
Y ahí estoy pintando.
Putting in new floors and carpet.
Poniendo las carpetas y
this
el piso.
Is the whole house better than my house.
Y dije, wow, esto es mejor que mi casa.
But to see them walk in.
Pero verlos entrar.
And hand them over those keys.
Y darle las llaves.
It's such a beautiful thing.
Fue algo hermoso.
I'm trying to hold back some tears, yo. But the reason why.
Pero la razón.
Is because in this season.
Es que en esta temporada.
God was breaking their limitations.
Dios estaba rompiendo sus limitaciones.
What the enemy meant for evil,
lo que el enemigo quiso para mal,
he turned it around for their good.
Él lo volteó para su bien.
Because it's real easy to walk into that house,
porque es fácil entrar
and
a esa
feel
casa,
like I don't belong here.
Y sentir, ay, yo no pertenezco.
But I feel the Lord is telling someone here tonight,
pero yo siento el Señor decirle,
there are rooms and houses and places that have already been prepared for you.
Hay casas, cuartos y lugares,
but the Lord is breaking the limits and the lid and the labels off of your life.
Rompiendo los límites y las etiquetas y las tapas de tu vida.
Because Abraham,
porque Abraham
had to come out of the tent,
tenía que salir de,
and look up at the
de
sky,
su tienda y ver los cielos.
And God says, Abraham, what do you see?
Y Dios le dice, Abraham, ¿qué tú ves?
So, well, I see a bunch of stars.
Bueno, yo veo muchas
Can
estrellas.
You count them?
¿Puedes contarlos?
No, I can't.
No, no puedo.
Because I'm a limitless God.
Porque soy un Dios sin límites.
Because you can't count your future.
Porque tú no puedes contar tu
Try
futuro.
To count the stars in the sky.
Trata de contar las estrellas en los
Try
cielos.
To count the grains of sand in the
Trata
sea.
De contar la tierra.
Can you count it?
¿Lo puedes contar?
No, God, that's impossible.
No, Dios, eso es imposible.
That's how your future looks like.
Así se ve tu futuro.
It's impossible.
Es imposible.
Can somebody just rejoice tonight and say, I serve a God with no limits. I serve a God with no limits.
Yo sirvo un Dios sin límites.
I serve a God with no limits.
Yo sirvo un Dios sin límites.
I serve a God with no limits.
Yo sirvo un Dios sin límites.
In the midst of the limitations.
En medio de estas limitaciones.
Jabez.
Jabez.
In verse number 10.
En versículo 10.
Praise a prayer.
Él ora una oración.
And he says, Lord God of Israel.
Y él dice, Dios de Israel.
In the middle of the label.
En medio de esa etiqueta.
In the middle of the lid.
En medio de esa tapa.
In the middle of their limitations.
En medio de esas limitaciones.
I'm going to pray to the limitless God.
Voy a orar al Dios de sin límites.
And he says, Lord.
Y él dice, Dios.
Would you bless me indeed?
Bendíceme.
Would you enlarge my territory?
Y ensancha mi territorio.
Everybody just touch your head. Slap yourself
solamente
on the head.
Tóquense.
Slap you. Now slap your neighbor. No, I'm just kidding.
Pégale a tu vecino.
Enlarge my territory.
Ensancha mi territorio.
Is breaking off the limitations and the lids off of your mind.
Eso está rompiendo los límites y las tapas de tu mente.
Because he prays a crazy prayer.
Porque él ora una oración muy loca.
How does the son of pain?
Cómo es que el hijo del dolor
begin to believe a limitless God.
Comienza a creerle a un Dios sin límites.
Would you enlarge my territory?
Ensancha mi territorio.
Enlarge. Can somebody just prophesy to
¿alguien
the future
puede profetizar a su futuro?
And say, God, enlarge my future.
Y digan, Señor, ensancha
allow
mi
me to
futuro.
Think higher than what I think.
Permíteme
I'm about to step into
alto.
Rooms, into places, and territories that are much greater than I look right now. I'm not going to allow the limitation. I'm not going to allow the lid. I'm not going to allow the label to limit what God wants to enlarge in my future.
No voy a permitir que yo mis pensamientos limite, que las tapas me limiten. No voy a permitir que Dios limite lo que Dios quiere hacer en mi futuro.
God is going to break it.
Dios lo va a romper.
And Jabez knew.
Y Jabez sabía
that what he needed in this season.
Que lo que él necesitaba en esta temporada.
When I say this, y'all better shout like you receive it.
Cuando yo diga esto, quiero que griten como
in
si lo creen.
In the middle of the label. In the middle of the label.
En medio de la etiqueta.
The lid and the limitations.
La tapa y las limitaciones.
He needed a prayer spirit.
Él necesitaba un espíritu de oración.
He needed a spirit of prayer over his life.
Él necesitaba un espíritu de oración.
Because he knew that prayer.
Porque él sabía que esa oración
could break every lid and every limitation.
Iba a romper toda limitación y toda tapa.
He said, if I could just get a spirit of prayer in my belly.
Y él dijo, si yo tomara un espíritu de
oración, I know that I'm so much greater on the inside than what the world has tried to label me on the outside.
Yo sé que yo estoy más grande por dentro que el mundo ha etiquetado sobre fuera.
And he prayed from his spirit.
Y él oró de su espíritu.
Some of you pray from your eyes.
Algunos oran por sus ojos.
But you gotta pray from your spirit.
Pero tienes que orar de tu espíritu.
I'm not praying according to what I see.
No estoy orando de acuerdo a lo que yo veo.
I'm praying according to what God put inside of me.
Estoy orando de acuerdo a lo que Dios ha puesto dentro de mí.
Noah, build an ark.
Construye un arca.
I can't even see the rain.
Ni puedo ver la lluvia.
Because the ark is not on the outside.
Porque el arca no está por fuera.
The ark is on the inside.
El arca está por dentro.
You already carry an ark on the inside.
Tú ya cargas esa arca por dentro.
Now you need to make it manifest on the outside.
Y ahora lo necesitas manifestar por fuera.
Jabez knew.
Jabez sabía.
I'm not going to allow the labels of my mama.
No voy a permitir las etiquetas de mi madre.
And the lids of her past.
Y las tapas de su pasado.
Put a limitation on my future.
Poner una limitación sobre mi futuro.
When I serve a God with no limits.
Cuando yo sirvo un Dios
sin límites. He says, God, enlarge my territory.
Y él dice, Dios ensancha mi territorio.
I prophesy that this year 2022.
Profetizo que este año 2022.
You're walking into a limitless year.
Estamos entrando a un año sin
the
límites.
The Lord is about to enlarge your territory.
El Señor está a punto de
ensanchar. He's about to enlarge
territorio.
Your name.
Está a punto de ensanchar tu
I
nombre.
Wish somebody would receive this tonight.
Quisiera
He's about to enlarge your future.
Esto. Está a punto de ensanchar tu futuro.
Band, y'all can come up here and just slowly help me out. And it says that your hand would be with me.
Y dice que tu mano esté conmigo.
Hear me, y'all.
Escúchenme.
Jabez needed his hand.
Jabez necesitaba su mano.
Over his life.
La mano de él sobre
and
su vida.
And then he says that you would keep me from evil.
Y dice y que me guardes de todo mal.
I see this image in my mind.
Y yo veo esta imagen en mi mente.
Jabez is saying, all I need is one of your hands to be on me.
Y Jabez está diciendo, solamente necesito que una de tus manos esté sobre
you know,
mí.
God is a God of two hands.
Porque Dios es un Dios de dos manos.
And he says, all I need is one of them.
Y él dice, solamente necesito una.
Just put one of them on me.
Solamente pon una mano sobre mí.
And with the other one.
Y con la otra.
Just keep the evil from me.
Solamente líbrame de mal.
Keep one hand over me.
Pon una mano sobre mí.
and keep the other hand working for him.
Y con la otra, la mano trabajando por
but
mí.
Check out this prayer.
Pero escuchen esta oración.
He says, God,
él dice, Dios,
if you would just bless me,
si solamente me bendijeras,
if you enlarge my territory,
si ensanchas mi territorio,
if I could, if you could just put your hand over my life,
si solamente puedes poner tu mano sobre mi vida,
it is a posture of submission, church.
Esa es la postura de ser.
I'm not just, I just don't want your hand over my life.
No solamente quiero tu mano sobre mi vida.
I want to submit under your hand.
Quiero someterme bajo tu mano.
And keep evil from me.
Y líbrame de todo mal.
That I may not cause pain.
Para que no padezca aflicción.
He says, I don't want to cause more pain.
Dice, no quiero causar más dolor.
Because my mama put something on me.
Porque mi madre puso algo sobre mí.
Because it was a generational label.
Porque era una generación. Etiqueta generacional.
But I don't want that label.
Pero yo no quiero esa etiqueta.
To continue on for generations.
Que continúe por generaciones.
So I need you.
Entonces necesito.
To bless me.
Que me bendigas.
To enlarge my territory.
Que me ensanches mi territorio.
To put your hand on me.
Que pongas tu mano sobre mí.
To keep me from evil.
Y que me libres de todo mal.
So that my future.
Para que mi futuro
won't look like what they labeled it like.
No se mire como lo que ellos etiquetaron.
But watch this.
Miren esto.
So that my future
para que mi futuro
can look like what you look like.
Se pueda ver como tú ves.
All Jabez wanted
todo lo que él quería
was heaven's value over his life.
Era el valor de los cielos sobre su vida.
And he decided it ends with me.
Y él decidió termina conmigo.
And that's it. That was his prayer.
Y eso fue todo, eso fue su oración.
Lord, would you bless me?
Señor, me bendices.
Enlarge my territory.
Ensancha mi territorio.
Put your hand on me.
Pon tu mano sobre
keep
mí.
Keep me from evil.
Guárdame de todo mal.
And it's like period. That's it.
Y eso fue todo.
And it almost like the although the Bible puts a little period.
Y aunque la Biblia pone un punto final.
Or it's almost like so that I won't cause pain.
Para que yo no pueda causar dolor.
And it's just like that's it.
Y es como si
it's like
fue todo.
An open-ended prayer.
Como
like,
si fuera una oración sin que no terminó.
Like God, I thank you for my food.
Como si uno dice gracias Señor por esta comida.
It's like in Jesus' name, amen.
Como que en el nombre de Jesús, amén.
God, I just pray that you stop.
Y Señor, yo oro que tú y solamente para.
And it almost seems as if Jabez doesn't finish asking God for something.
Y pareciera como que Jabez no termina de
preguntarle
a Dios por algo.
And I have this image in my head, Kyle.
Y yo tengo esta imagen en mi mente.
That he's like, God,
que él está como que Dios.
If you just bless me,
si tú me bendices.
And enlarge my territory.
Y ensanchas mi territorio.
And would you put your hand on me?
Que si pones tu mano sobre
mí. And keep me from evil.
Y guárdame de todo mal.
And God just gave it to him. And it's almost like he was praying the prayer.
Y es como si Dios él estaba haciendo la oración.
And it's almost like as if God doesn't even let him finish.
Y es como si Dios ni lo deja terminar.
And he says he granted him what he was asking.
Porque dice que él le concedió su petición.
But God, I just need. God says, it's yours. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. Solamente necesito.
Y Dios dice, es tuyo. Es tuyo. Es tuyo.
This is what I love about this, y'all.
Es lo que me encanta de esto.
That in this season.
Que en esta temporada.
Your prayer life.
Tu vida de oración.
It's not going to be after the blessing.
No va a estar detrás de la bendición.
As much as it is going to be after the journey with the blesser.
Sino va a estar detrás de la jornada con el que bendice.
Because this is what we call a limitless prayer.
Porque esto es lo que llamamos la jornada sin límite.
A limitless prayer.
Una oración sin límite.
And Jabez says, God.
Y Jabez dice, Dios.
You're a limitless God.
Tú eres un Dios sin límite.
God granted it.
Y Dios le concedió.
And what I heard the Lord say.
Y yo escuché al Señor decir.
When you pray limitless prayers.
Cuando tú oras oraciones sin límites.
A limitless prayer.
Una oración sin límite.
Is when God does what only God can do.
Es cuando Dios hace solamente lo que Dios puede hacer.
When you pray.
Cuando tú oras.
The foundation of your prayer.
El fundamento de tu oración.
Is a limitless supernatural God.
Es un Dios sobrenatural sin límites.
And I believe.
Y yo creo
that in this season,
que en esta temporada
what God is doing,
lo que Dios está haciendo
is God,
es que Dios
you determine how you're gonna bless me.
Tú vas a determinar cómo me vas a bendecir.
But this is the other response.
Pero esta es la otra respuesta.
Not only will God determine how he's going to bless you.
No solamente Dios determina cómo te va a bendecir.
But you determine my response to your blessing.
Pero tú también determinas mi respuesta a la bendición.
There are too many natural prayers.
Hay muchas oraciones naturales.
God, if you just give me this,
Señor, si solamente me das esto,
then I'll do that.
Entonces yo haré
if
eso.
You do this for me,
si tú haces esto por
then
mí,
I'll do that for me.
Entonces yo voy a hacer eso.
This ain't a business, yo.
No es un negocio.
Your prayer life is not a transaction.
Tu vida de oración no es una transacción.
Your prayer should be God.
Tu oración debería de ser Dios.
Bless me.
Bendíceme.
Do whatever you want to do with me.
Haz cualquier cosa que tú quieras conmigo.
And determine how I respond to that blessing.
Y determina cómo yo respondo
because
a esa bendición.
Because I'm not after the blessing.
Porque yo no estoy detrás de la bendición.
I'm after a journey with the one that blesses
yo
me.
Yo estoy detrás de una jornada con el que me bendice.
Jabez understood it.
Y Jabez entendió eso.
And he understood.
Y él entendió.
The God that he serves was a God with no limitations.
Que el Dios que él sirve es el Dios sin limitaciones.
For the next few minutes.
Y por los próximos minutos.
I want to prophesy.
Yo quiero profetizar.
A prophetic word.
Una palabra profética.
That the Lord wants to prophesy over this house.
Que el Señor quiere profetizar sobre esta casa.
But when we prophesy something over Revive Church.
Pero cuando nosotros profetizamos sobre la casa de Revive.
I want you to receive it as if it's for your house.
Yo quiero que tú lo recibas como que si fuera para
because
tu casa.
What's over this house
porque lo que está sobre esta casa
is coming over your house.
Viene sobre tu casa.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't know what how you want to posture yourself to receive.
Yo no sé cómo que te quieres posturar para recibir esto.
But whether that's standing up,
si te quieres parar,
whether that's on your face,
si quieres ponerte de cara,
whether that's you at the altar,
si quieres venir al
altar,
whether
that's you walking around,
si tú quieres estar caminando,
I want you to posture yourself however it is that you receive the word of God.
Quiero que te pongas en una posición para recibir la palabra de Dios.
And I just want you to open up your hands.
Y si pueden abrir sus manos.
As if you're going to receive something.
Como si vas a recibir algo.
If you need to get up of your chair,
si necesitas parar.
If you want to get at the altar,
si quieres venir
if you want to get on your knees,
si quieres ponerte de
however
rodillas,
it is that you receive from
como
God.
Tú recibas
come on,
de
let's
Dios.
Just begin to invite His presence into
vamos,
this room. God, we invite
en
you.
Su presencia.
There it is, there it is, there it is. God,
está.
We just invite the Holy Spirit.
Invitamos a la presencia del
we invite your presence, Lord, to overtake tonight. Invitamos all we want is what you want, God.
Queremos solamente lo que tú quieres para nosotros.
Oh, that you would bless us, oh God.
Que tú nos bendigas.
That you would enlarge our mind.
Que tú ensanches nuestra
enlarge our territory.
Ensanche nuestro territorio.
That we will not be the label of our past.
Que no seamos las etiquetas de nuestro pasado.
We will be the label of our process. But Lord, tonight
Señor,
we pray
noche, oramos,
that the joy of the victory,
que el gozo de la victoria,
let the joy of the victory,
que el gozo de la victoria,
let the joy of the victory,
que el gozo de la victoria.
Let the joy, let the joy, let the joy.
El gozo.
Father, pour out your joy over this house.
Padre, derrama de tu gozo en esta casa.
Pour your joy, pour your joy.
Derrama de tu gozo.
Pour your joy, pour your joy. Pour your joy, pour your joy. Over our lives, over this house. Pour your joy out. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Let the joy of the Lord. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength. Let the joy of the Lord be your strength. Let the joy, let the joy, let the joy. Fill this house with joy. Fill this house with joy. Fill this house with joy. Let the joy of the Lord be our strength. Come on, receive it, receive it. Let the joy of the Lord.
Vamos, recibe el gozo del Señor.
Let it come over you. There it is. Receive the joy. Receive the joy.
Recibe el gozo.
You find healing in the joy. You find healing in the joy. You find freedom in the joy. You find deliverance in the joy. You're a God of our joy. You're the God of our joy. come on, prophesy, prophesy. There it is, sir. Come on. Come on, somebody receive the joy of the Lord. Come on, open up your hands. Open up your hands to receive.
Abre tus manos para recibir.
Let the joy. Your mourning into dancing. Your sorrow into joy. Your mourning into dancing. Your sorrow into joy. Let the mourning into dance. There is healing. Let this house, the joy of the Lord. Let this house be filled, the joy of the Lord. Let this house be filled, the joy of the Lord. Let this house be filled with the joy of the Lord. Let your house be filled with the joy of the Lord. Let your house be filled with the joy of the Lord. Let your house be filled with the joy of the Lord. Let your house be filled with the joy of the Lord. Let your house be filled with the joy of the Lord. Let your house be filled with the joy of the Lord. Tonight, open up your hands to receive.
Abren sus manos para recibir.
Stay right there, stay right there, stay right there. For the Lord says tonight,
el Señor dice,
this year 2022,
este año 2022
will be a year with no limitations.
Será el año sin límites.
Every stony place,
cualquier área,
every stuck place,
de cada área
atorada.
Atorado.
Every stuck place.
Toda área donde te atoraste.
The Lord says it breaks open tonight.
El Señor dice se rompen esta noche.
Because you will enter into the year of limitless flow.
Porque entrarás al año donde hay fluyo sin límites.
There is a limitless flow.
Hay un fluyo sin límites.
A limitless flow of resources.
Un fluyo de recursos.
A limitless flow in the river of God.
En el río de Dios sin límites.
Spring up a well.
Que derrama de.
There will be no limits of my spirit, says the Lord.
Dice el Señor que no habrá límite de su espíritu.
And you will revive the flow of the Spirit of God in your life.
Y avivarás el fluir de Dios en tu vida.
There it is, there it is. Revive the flow, revive the flow.
Aviva el fluir.
Revive the flow, revive the flow.
Aviva el fluir.
The flow of his spirit.
El fluir de su espíritu.
No more stuck place.
Ya no vas a estar en lugares atorados.
No more stony place.
No andas en
no more hard place.
Duros.
The river's gonna flow, the river's gonna flow,
el
the river's
río
gonna
va
flow.
Fluir. El río va a fluir.
There is no limits in the spirit.
No hay límites en el espíritu.
The Lord says there's no limits on my Holy Spirit.
El Señor dice no hay límites con mi Espíritu Santo.
There will be no limits on my power.
No va a haber límites en mi poder.
There will be no limits on my presence.
No va a haber límites en mi presencia.
There will be no limits on my hand.
No va a haber límites en mi mano.
The dam breaks open tonight.
Las barreras se rompen en
the
esta
barrier
noche.
Breaks open tonight.
Las barreras se rompen en esta noche.
God is breaking the barrier of religion.
Vamos a romper las barreras de religión.
God is breaking the barrier of poverty.
Dios está rompiendo las barreras de pobreza.
God is breaking the barrier of greed.
Dios está rompiendo la barrera de.
God is breaking the barrier of perversion.
Dios está rompiendo las barreras de perversión.
And God says, I'm about to infiltrate every corner of San Antonio.
Y Dios dice que va a infiltrar cada esquina de San Antonio.
Because there will be no limitation to my spirit.
Porque no habrá limitaciones a su espíritu.
The Lord says, watch what I do in this year 2022.
El Señor dice, mira lo que yo voy a hacer este año 2022.
It is not a coincidence.
No es coincidencia.
That people from Uvalde, Texas are here tonight.
Que hay gente de Uvalde, Texas en esta noche.
Because people will no longer come because of the river walk.
Porque la gente ya no vendrá por el río.
People will begin to come to San Antonio because of the river of my spirit.
La gente va a venir a San Antonio por el fluir del río de Dios.
They're going to be attracted to the river of the Spirit of God.
Van a estar atraídos por el río de Dios.
So God says, jump in the river, jump in the river.
Y Dios dice, métete al río.
Jump in the river, jump in the river.
Brinca del río.
Jump in the river.
Brinca del río.
Jump in the river.
Brinca del río.
Jump in the river.
Jump in the river. Jump in the river.
Brinca en el río.
Listen, the Lord begins to break the barrier.
El Señor comienza a romper las barreras.
The barrier over San Antonio.
Las barreras sobre San Antonio.
The Lord spoke to me and he said this.
El Señor me habló y me dijo esto.
The enemy trying to put a barrier.
El enemigo trató de poner una barrera.
And a limitation over the church of San Antonio.
Limitación sobre la iglesia de San Antonio.
The body of Christ in San Antonio.
El cuerpo de Cristo aquí en San Antonio.
Especially in Hispanic churches.
Especialmente en iglesias hispanas.
Now we are not limited to be a Hispanic church.
Y no estamos limitados a ser una iglesia hispana.
But you do have Hispanic pastors.
Pero sí tienes pastores hispanos.
But the Lord spoke to me and he said,
pero el Señor me habló y me dijo,
I'm going to use
yo
this
voy a
house
usar esta casa
to break the barrier of the limitation on growth in the body of Christ.
Para romper ese límite de crecimiento en el cuerpo de Cristo.
Because Hispanic churches,
porque las iglesias hispanas,
have not been able to break growth barriers.
Porque las iglesias hispanas no han podido romper ese crecimiento.
But the Lord says through Revive Church.
Pero el Señor dice a través de Iglesia Revive.
Because you honored my presence.
Porque honran mi presencia.
And because I'm always the guest of honor.
Y siempre soy el invitado.
I will begin to attract all men unto this house.
Yo voy a atraer a los hombres a esta casa.
Come on, I'm going to begin to draw all men unto my presence.
Yo voy a atraer los hombres a mi presencia.
And the Lord is saying that every growth barrier.
Y el Señor está diciendo que toda barrera de crecimiento.
Over this house.
Sobre esta casa.
And over the church in San Antonio.
Y sobre la iglesia en San Antonio.
The lid is coming off in 2022.
La tapa se cae en el 2022.
Because the dam of religion breaks open.
Porque la barrera de la religión se rompe.
The barrier of religion breaks open.
La barrera de la religión se rompe.
And just like Jabez said.
Y así como dijo Jabez.
Lord, would you enlarge my territory?
Señor, ensancha mi territorio.
The Lord says limitless territory is coming.
El Señor dice territorio sin límites viene.
Somebody better open up their hands and receive this.
Alguien abra sus manos a recibir esto.
Limitless territory.
Territorio sin límites.
In real estate.
En
raíces. Limitless territory.
En
of property.
Territorios, propiedades.
Limitless territory of land.
Territorio sin límite de tierra.
Limitless territory in houses.
Territorio sin límites en casas.
Businessmen and women that are in this house.
Hombres de negocios en esta casa.
The Lord says.
El Señor dice.
Begin to believe a limitless expansion.
Empieza a creer por una expansión sin límites.
Because in the spirit I see that you're about to cross borders.
Porque en el espíritu yo veo que vas a cruzar fronteras.
Hear me, business people.
Escúchenme, gente de
negocio. The Lord says I'm opening up the nations to you.
El Señor dice estoy abriendo las naciones a ti.
Latin America.
El Latinoamérica.
Europe.
Europa.
Africa.
Africa.
The Lord says I'm about to open up nations.
El Señor dice estoy a punto de abrir naciones.
And I'm about to expand business that is about to cross regions.
Y estoy a punto de expandir negocios que van a cruzar regiones.
I specifically feel tonight.
Yo específicamente siento en esta noche.
That there's somebody here in this room.
Que hay alguien en este lugar.
That has been praying for Asia.
Que ha estado orando por Asia.
And the Lord says, I'm about to open up Asia to you.
Y el Señor dice, estoy a punto de abrir Asia por ti.
Because I see Japan and China.
Porque yo veo a Japón y a China.
But the Lord says, Europe.
Pero el Señor dice, Europa.
Is about to expand.
Está a punto de expandir.
I don't know who this is for.
Yo no sé para quién es esto.
But God says, you're about to break the barrier.
Pero Dios dice, estás a romper esa barrera.
And if you allow me to go before you,
y si tú permites que yo vaya delante de
my
ti,
hand is upon your head.
Mi mano está sobre tu cabeza.
And I'm about to open up the Red Sea in your favor.
Y estoy a punto de abrir el Mar Rojo a tu favor.
Real estate, property, land, houses, businesses will expand in 2022.
Raíces, propiedades, casas, negocios se va a abrir a ti en el 2022.
Limitless territory.
Territorio sin límite.
The Lord says this year.
El Señor dice que este año.
I'm going to begin to equip.
Voy a comenzar a equipar.
2022. Is a year of equipping.
Como el año de equipar.
If you feel called to be a minister.
Si tú sientes el llamado de ser un ministro.
If you feel called
to prophesy,
si tú sientes el llamado a profetizar,
to pastor,
a pastorear,
to evangelize,
a evangelizar,
to teach,
a enseñar,
the Lord this year,
el Señor este año,
this is the year of limitless equipping.
Este es el año del el equipar sin límites.
We're going to begin to equip ministers.
Vamos a comenzar a equipar ministros.
We're going to equip you for every good work.
Vamos a equiparte para toda buena obra.
The Lord out of this house,
el de esta casa,
will begin to equip the next prophetic voices of this generation.
Dios va a equipar las próximas voces proféticas de esta generación.
A generation of intercessors are beginning to arise out of this house.
La próxima generación de intercesores comienza a salir de esta casa.
You will be ministers of the word.
Ministros de la palabra.
You'll be ministers of the word.
Serás ministro de la palabra.
There will be revelation that will begin to flow.
Habrá revelación.
You'll begin to walk in your assignment.
Empezarás a caminar en tu asignación.
And walk in your purpose.
E caminar en tu propósito.
The Lord says, skillful men and women.
El Señor dice, gente con talento.
Hear me.
Escuchen.
The Lord is going to begin to define your skill.
El Señor va a comenzar a definir.
God is going to begin to define your skill.
El Señor va a definir tu talento.
And your gifting enters into development.
O tu habilidad y tu don entra en desarrollamiento.
There's many of you that are called to minister in the church of Jesus Christ.
Hay muchos de ustedes que son llamados a ministrar en la iglesia de Jesucristo.
And in 2022,
y en este año 2022,
your pastors,
tus pastores,
have a mandate to equip you for the next work.
Tienen un mandato para equiparte para lo próximo.
We're going to empower leaders.
Queremos empoderar a líderes.
We want to train and equip.
Queremos equipar y entrenarte.
And the Lord says, out of this house,
y el Señor dice que de esta casa,
begins limitless equipping.
Viene equipar sin límites.
Limitless equipping.
Equipar sin límites.
Throw up those hands.
Levanten sus manos.
Father, we pray,
Padre, oramos,
that you begin to bring limitless thinking.
Que tú empieces a traer
thinking.
Pensamientos sin límites.
You bring limitless believing.
Tú empieces a traer creer sin límites.
You bring limitless giving.
Tú empieces a traer el dar sin límites.
You begin to bring limitless faith.
Tú empieces a traer fe sin límites.
Limitless wisdom.
Sabiduría sin límites.
Limitless power.
Poder sin límites.
Limitless prophecy.
Profecía sin límites.
Father, we pray that you bring limitless living.
Padre, oramos que tú traes un cielo
and
sin
we
límites.
Prophesy over this house and your house.
Y profetizamos sobre esta y esa casa
that
y tu
the
casa.
Barriers break tonight. Every barrier breaks.
Que todo barrera se
every
rompe.
Resistance breaks.
Toda resistencia se rompe.
So we break it tonight.
Entonces lo rompemos en esta noche.
We break the limitation.
Rompemos las limitaciones.
We break off the lid.
Rompemos las tapas.
We break the limit.
Rompemos los límites.
We break the labels.
Rompemos las etiquetas.
Come on, worship him, worship him, worship him.
Vamos, adóralo, adóralo.
Limitless miracles.
No bounds, I see it all around. No limits, no bounds, I see increase all around. No limits, no bounds, I see increase all around. No limits, no bounds, I see increase all around. No limits, no boundaries, I see increase all around me. No limits, no boundaries, I see increase all around me. No limits, no boundaries, I see increase all around me. No limits, no boundaries, I see increase all around me.
Come on, receive it, Revive Church.
Vamos, recíbelo, recíbelo.
Come on, open up your hands.
Levanta tus manos.
Revive the flow.
Aviva el fluir.
Spring up that well, God. Flow like the river. Spring up a well.
flow like a river, a river with no limits. Enter into a limitless flow, a flow of your spirit. Lift up your hands, let's pray. Father, I thank you.
Padre, te doy gracias.
For every prophetic word.
Por la palabra profética.
That was released tonight.
Que fue desatada en esta noche.
And every prophetic word.
Y toda palabra profética.
That shall be released.
Que será desatada.
For the rest of this month.
Por el resto de este mes.
We promise.
Prometemos.
And we are committed.
Y estamos comprometidos
to stewarding this word in this month.
A manejar esta palabra.
May you grace us,
Señor, danos la gracia
to steward well
para manejar bien
this prophetic word.
Esta palabra profética.
May we walk in the fulfillment of this word.
Que caminemos en el cumplimiento de esta palabra.
That the seed of this word,
de la semilla de esta palabra,
would not fall to the ground.
Que no se caiga al piso.
But it is sown into the hearts of your people.
Pero que es sembrada en los corazones de tu gente.
There shall be no limits.
No habrá límites.
Come on, prophesy. There shall be no limits.
Profetiza, no habrá límites.
There will be no limit to my thinking.
No habrá límites en mi familia.
There will be no limit to my believing.
No hay límites en mi creer.
There will be no limit to my giving.
No habrá límites en mi dar.
There will be no limit to my faith.
No habrá límites en mi fe.
There will be no limit.
No habrá límites.
No limit in my mind.
En mi mente.
No limit in my life.
No habrá límites en
in
mi
Jesus
vida.
Name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Put your hands together tonight and give him praise.
Pongan sus manos juntas y dale gloria.
Thank you, Father.